Hi guys, may God bless us all with all the success we deserve. By the way, the picture on your screen is a fluid parcel. You may not be able to imagine what the shape of a fluid parcel looks like. How about thinking of this picture as a box-shaped jelly? When our fingertip pushes one part of the jelly box will deform uniquely according to the direction of the force. Whatever the shape, it seems like the volume of the jelly box is constant. Because basically jelly consists of water, which is an incompressible substance. Some of the surfaces are displaced, translationally moved, or bubbled. This means that each surface of the jelly experiences a combination of normal stress and shear stress simultaneously with different values. How do we formulate this mathematically? Just put the jelly box into a three-dimensional Cartesian coordinate system. The jelly box has six surfaces. Each surface has a different normal direction. Let's start from the surface that has a normal direction towards the positive z-axis. This surface can experience normal stress, sigma zz. Here we use two subscripts in the stress symbol. The first subscript is the normal direction of the surface. The second subscript is the direction from which the force is acting. So, this side will experience shear stress, tau zy. And this side is tau zx. One surface of the jelly box will experience three types of stress. We can analyze the other surfaces. The bottom surface. The right surface. The left surface. The front surface. And the back surface. Now consider the subscript of each stress. On the top and bottom surfaces, the subscript of this surface is the same, z. Why is that? Since stress is a scalar quantity, it does not need a direction. Writing the subscript as z is sufficient. The same is true for tau zy and tau zx. Although there are 18 stress values on your screen, there are actually only 9 different stress. These stress are often written in matrix form. All these stress values are known as the stress tensor. So, each jelly has a different stress tensor value. When getting the same force in the same direction, it is possible that the jelly shape changes differently. Because each jelly box has a different stress tensor value. Hopefully, a brief explanation can provide an overview of the stress tensor. Happy learning, everyone.
Yeah, I'm about to fade away. Cause every time I wake up, I feel like it's Monday. Something's going wrong with all the chemicals up in my brain. All of a sudden, I don't look at anything the same way. Gotta build up of my thoughts sitting in an ashtray.